Today on SciGuys, electric fields and plasma tubes.
Welcome to SciGuys. I'm Ryan.
And I'm Mark. And on today's episode, we're going to be exploring electric fields with a plasma tube.
We love you, Nikola Tesla.
Yeah, we said Tesla. What are you going to do about it, Edison? A plasma globe or tube creates a high-frequency alternating current field. This field is at a high enough frequency that it excites the electrons of a noble gas, causing them to emit light.
The equipment you're going to need for this episode includes a plasma tube or globe,
and a variety of light bulbs. We're not dealing with anything particularly hazardous in this episode, but please keep in mind that these fluorescent light bulbs have mercury vapor inside of them, so it's best not to break them. Also, for younger viewers, it would not be a bad idea to have parental supervision.
The only steps for this experiment are to power up your plasma tube and take your light bulb and put it within the vicinity of the tube. Now let's try this experiment out with the lights off. With the lights off, we can clearly see that even though there is no contact between the bulb and the plasma tube, the light bulb will still light up within close proximity to the plasma tube. Next, let's try this out with a fluorescent tube instead of a bulb. As you can see, we get the same results with the tube as we did with the bulb. Let's look at this experiment a little closer. A plasma globe consists primarily of two components. The first is an enclosed sphere pressurized with a mixture of inert gases such as xenon, neon, or argon. The second is an electrode placed within the sphere, which is capable of generating a high-frequency, high-voltage, alternating current with the help of a transformer and an oscillator, which produce a much higher frequency and voltage of electricity than you would find in an average household outlet. When the globe is turned on, the alternating current charges up the electrode with a lot of electrons. These electrons want to find the easiest path away from the electrode, and the only nearby object that they are attracted to is the glass in our sphere, causing them to jump from the electrode to the glass walls. As the electrons quickly jump from the electrode to the glass, they bump into the inert gases contained within the sphere. This contact transfers energy to our gas molecules, exciting them. This excitement is short-lived. The gas molecules will almost immediately release the additional energy in the form of light, which appear in our experiment as the arcs or tendrils of lightning. The charged up electrode and quickly moving electrons generate an electromagnetic field. This field isn't contained within the glass walls of our sphere and extends beyond the glass. When we bring our compact fluorescent bulb within close proximity of the electromagnetic field, the gases inside our bulb gain energy, exciting them, which is quickly released as light, which can be seen in our experiment. The type of gases used inside the sphere will change the color and shape of the arcs as well as the amount of energy needed to create them.
Well, that's it for electric fields and plasma tubes. Thanks for watching.
If you enjoyed this episode, let us know in the comments below and subscribe for future episodes.
And remember to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter.
And if you have any questions related to this episode, or about science in general, let us know in the comments below or message us on Facebook and we'll try to help you out as best possible. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Bye.
Here at SciGuys, we're always curious how experiments turn out. So if you do these experiments at home, share a video or photo of them with us on our Facebook or Google Plus page. But remember to always ask your parents' permission before you share any photos or videos.